guys, this video gives you an introductory glimpse into a very interesting field called knot theory. Haven't we all come across situations where our earphones are highly entangled, or sometimes our laptop chargers? Disentangling them is definitely a headache. Studying such entanglements is exactly what knot theorists do, though the knots they study are more complicated. Are you wondering why would anyone study knots? Knots arise at several important places, like in the protein molecules of your body, or even in natural structures that chemists study. Knots are also manufactured artificially in labs for various purposes. Understanding the mathematical enigma of these knots can help understand the naturally occurring knots. A knot is basically a collection of lots and lots of crossings, and at each crossing, one thread goes over another thread. There's a way in which knot theorists represent a crossing on paper. If a thread goes under another thread, it leaves a gap where the other thread goes over it. In these two cases, thread A goes over thread B in case 1, and thread A goes under thread B in case 2. A gap does not mean the thread is broken. A simple loop without any crossings is what knot theorists call the unknot or the trivial knot. Suppose I take an unknot and cut it at a point to get a thread that is free at both ends. I now use this thread to construct the simplest non-trivial knot. For that purpose, I take this thread and this time I let one of its free ends pass under itself and then over itself. I take care of the representation of the crossing and it goes under itself again. I glue these two ends together. This drawing right here is quite messy, so I'll redraw the knot in a neater manner. All I'm doing here is redrawing the same knot. The resulting knot we get is what knot theorists call the trefoil knot. If you wish to disentangle it into the unknot, it's not possible unless you cut the trefoil knot at some point. This highly complicated knot you see can in fact be disentangled into the unknot. Let me ask you a question. Given a knot, can you give an algorithm to tell if it can be disentangled into an unknot without actually trying to disentangle it? This is a very interesting question, and in fact, an algorithm was given by Wolfgang Haeken in the year 1961, although it is so complicated that more than half a century later, no one has been able to give an efficient code to implement his algorithm. If you wish to start studying advanced knot theory formally, you would be entering a fascinating field called algebraic topology and would require knowledge of abstract algebra, point set topology, and several other related fields. Although the field of knot theory developed much later compared to other fields, discoveries happen all the time. Only recently, a graduate student from America solved a knot theory problem that had remained unsolved for several decades. I hope to give you a glimpse into the actual mathematics of knot theory, which can get really fascinating, in some of the subsequent videos. Till then, goodbye, and thanks a lot for watching this video.